Okay, so a tax collector and a Pharisee went up to the temple to pray. What's it sound like? It sounds like a joke, doesn't it? A priest, a rabbi, and a minister went up to the temple to pray. I went online to find priest, rabbi, and minister jokes, and they're almost none of them I can tell you. A priest and a rabbi walked into a bar. The minister ducked. Priest, rabbi, and minister walked into a bar, and the bartender looked at them and said, "What is this, a joke?" I guess I'll move on. I'm going to be here all week, to enjoy my shows. It sounds like a joke. A priest and a rabbi went into a bar. A tax collector and a Pharisee went into the temple. It is a setup, and we kind of know the roles that people are to play. As I read the rabbi, minister, and priest jokes, almost invariably the rabbi gets the good lines, the priest is the butt of the joke, and the minister is kind of a third wheel. Okay. We can do this with other groups, can't we, and other types of people. Nancy Pelosi and Mitch McConnell went up to the Capitol. Okay, we know how this is going to go. A reconciling Methodist and a Wesley Covenant Association Methodist went into the church to pray. Okay, we know who we're going to boo, we know who we're going to cheer, and so on. An immigrant and an ICE official went into a bar. Okay, we know how this is going to go. So a tax collector and a Pharisee went up to the temple to pray. In those days, it would have been heard that the tax collector is the bad guy. The tax collector collaborated with the occupying Roman Empire. The tax collector was a fundraiser for the hated Romans. The Romans would take money from the temple treasury to pay for their projects. So not only was the tax collector in cahoots with the Romans, he would have been actually kind of robbing the temple in which he was praying. So the crowd would have booed him when Jesus said, we know who this guy is. He's the bad guy. The Pharisee would have been the good guy. The Pharisees walked their talk. They actually, what they preached, they actually did. The Pharisees were religious leaders who were trying to make the scriptures and religion relevant to their day. They would have been seen as the liberals. And if Jesus was going to be part of any religious group, he was probably a Pharisee. And this prayer that the Pharisee prays is something really right out of Deuteronomy 26. In Deuteronomy 26, it says, when you bring your offering to the priest, when you bring it to the temple, you shall say, I have brought my offering to the Lord, and my father was a wandering Aramean, and the Lord delivered us from captivity and brought us to this wonderful land. And when the priest receives your offering, you shall say to the priest, I have obeyed the law, I have cared for the widow, I have cared for the orphan, I have cared for the immigrant, I have obeyed the law. The Pharisee in this story is not bragging. He's saying what he is supposed to say. When you give an offering, you say, this is how I've obeyed the law. I think And so the Pharisee, it can be argued, is not boasting or bragging. He's expressing gratitude. Now, this reading of the parable still leaves me with some questions. It says, the tax collector beat his breast and said, have mercy on me. And he went home justified. And I think, did he change? Did he change? Or did he just go up every day to the temple beating his breast and saying, woe unto me, poor me? I mean, after a while you want to say, be quiet and change. Quit your job that's exploiting our people. Quit your job that's collaborating with the Romans. Get a new life. Does the guy change? And with the Pharisee, he does say, I thank you that I am not like other people. Okay, that sounds arrogant, doesn't it? Have we ever said, there but by the grace of God go I? Have we ever looked at somebody and said, I thank you that I'm not in their mess? I have. On a positive note, every Pride Parade, when we come down, I love Pride Parades, and when we come north on High Street, and come down that rise, right where you see the mob waiting for the parade in the Short North. I'd love to come down that hill and see the mob of people just waiting to cheer me. it's a highlight of my year. It's just exhilarating to come down into that mob of cheering people. And I usually think to myself, I am so glad I am at King Avenue where I can be in this parade and where I can celebrate everybody's humanity and everybody's orientation. And how happy I am I'm not at another church that doesn't support LGBT persons. So I do that prayer. I thank you that I was appointed here, not somewhere else. Kind of sounds arrogant. So, in that reading of the parable, I still have questions. Today, that parable is heard almost the exact opposite of the way it would have been heard in the first century, isn't it? The hero of the story, in our hearing, is the tax collector. Is the guy who beats his breast and says he's a miserable sinner and he needs God's help. And the Pharisee becomes the self-righteous, arrogant, full of himself person. The Pharisee becomes the guy that doesn't walk the talk. The Pharisee is the person who doesn't try to make religion relevant to the current day. The Pharisee is the person we boo. The Pharisee is what's wrong with the church nowadays. We can tick off what's wrong with the church, and it's just full of too many Pharisees. The Pharisee is just saying, Jesus told this parable for those who trusted in their own righteousness and held others in contempt. We don't know who he's telling that parable to. We assume he's telling it to the Pharisees to put him in their place. Doesn't say that. He could be telling it to his disciples. He could be telling it to me. Because I do that. I trust in my own righteousness. I'm not like that other person. And I do hold other people in contempt. It's a tough parable. Because sometimes we all qualify as the person. I think of what Paul writes about that what I want to do, I don't, and that what I don't want to do, I do, and there is no help in me. And who can deliver me from this situation? And it's a tough situation to be in. The meaning of this parable hangs on the word. Greek word para, which is translated as, in the parable, as instead of, or in place of. I tell you, Jesus says, this man, the tax collector, went down to his home justified instead of the Pharisee. Para, instead of the Pharisee. Para can mean in place of or instead of. Like paramedic is instead of a doctor. Paralegal, instead of a lawyer or in place of a lawyer. And so when we read it as that preposition para, as instead of, it's, well, either the Pharisee or the tax collector. It's either Mitch McConnell or Nancy Pelosi. It's either the liberal or the conservative pastor. It's one or the other, instead of. And that justified is went down belonging, went down home belonging, instead of. So we see it as, it can't be both. It can't be both. It's one or the other. Choose. Para can also be understood as alongside. I tell you, this man, the tax collector, went down to his home justified, belonging, alongside the Pharisee. Parallel lines beside each other. This man went down to his home alongside. They're both justified. They're both, how does that change our meaning? We want to throw one person out of the church, and this reading says they're both in the church. It's a very different meaning. And what if Jesus meant that? The one we're booing belongs as much as we do. The third way para can be read is because of. I tell you, this tax collector went down to his own justified belonging because of the Pharisee. It's the Pharisee who justifies the tax collector. That's kind of even harder to swallow. I think Jesus likes to make life hard for us. I think the reading of alongside churches in Utah and Texas, it has an impact way beyond. Because of Mr. Huggins, who wanted to be alongside others, much good has been done. Have you ever worked on a project at school or at work where there might be three or four people on the project and you have to work together? Okay, Chris hates those. That's interesting that the director of the choir hates that people have to work together. Okay. Have you ever been on those? And there's one person that seems to always do the work, right? There's one person that's pretty smart and kind of can organize it. And then there's one person that seldom shows up, right? And you all get the same grade? Okay, you've all been, and okay. Have any of you been the person who seldom shows up? No. No. That's what I think this is. It's that working together where in the end, the project comes out fine. And the project benefits because of the good that people do for it, the impact that they do. And my guess is that person who hardly ever shows up does make a contribution. But even as they're caring, the result is a good one. And who wants to begrudge the good result? I tell you, this one went down to his home belonging alongside the other one because of the other one. We're all in it together. So we take communion.